Hey guys, welcome to High on Tech.
My name is Prince and welcome to my first ever YouTube video. For the first video, I wanted to make something special and want to like make a tribute video to the phone that I've used for the past 3 years, which is the Google Pixel 2 XL right here. I've used this phone for over 3 years and I absolutely love this phone. I'm going to go over some of the features of this phone, why I love this phone, and you know, just talk about the phone in general. So without any further ado, let's get started. So here you can see the Pixel 2 XL that I had. It's in the just black color. There was one more color available at the launch, which was the white black, also called the Panda Pixel. That was in shortage, so the only option I had was the Pixel 2 XL in just black, which I still like. Going around the phone, this has a 6-inch OLED display that was manufactured by LG at the time. There's two dual front-firing speakers, one at the top, one at the bottom, which I absolutely love. There's an 8-megapixel front camera. There's a 12.2 megapixel rear camera with a rear fingerprint scanner, a G logo, the volume up and down keys on the side, the power button on the top, and a USB-C port for charging at the bottom. And as you can see, there's no headphone jack whatsoever. This was the first Pixel phone to drop the headphone jack as well. Looking around at the build quality, this phone has the upper one-third made of glass and the lower is metal, but it's covered by this plastic coating for, I guess, better grip. And in the front, there's Gorilla Glass 5, which was the best at the time. And looking at the durability of the phone, you can see there's some color, that paint that's coming off of the phone, but I guess that's normal wear and tear over 3 years. Considering the fact that I haven't had a case on this phone or a glass guard, and it still managed to stay intact for 3 years, says a lot about the durability of the phone. One of the features that comes with this phone is squeeze for assistant. So these two sides here are like pressure sensitive. So if you press these, the Google Assistant should come up. So like that, the Google Assistant comes up. It's a neat feature that I like to use all the time because I guess Google Assistant is like the smartest assistant out of Siri and Alexa. The other thing that I love about this phone is the software. It's snappy, it's responsive. The phone opens apps fairly well, you know, it responds to the touch. It has the latest Android 11 version, which was updated by Google in September. Google promised 3 years of updates for this phone, which basically ended in this year, I guess. So yeah, this phone won't be any updates in the future as well. But yeah, overall, I've enjoyed this phone. Another feature that I love with this software is the Now Playing feature, where if there's a song playing in the background, the phone will automatically display the name of that song here above the battery percentage. This feature works with airplane mode on, so it does not mean that it's using any data. And yeah, that's basically it. Apart from that, you can see like being a three-year-old Android phone, it's still quite responsive. And that's what I love about the Google software experience overall. The other thing I loved about this phone was the camera. I believe when this phone came out, it had the best camera ever. It also topped the iPhone at the time. So yeah, Google had some pretty big claims with this camera. I'll show you guys a couple of pictures that I've taken over the past 3 years, and you guys can be the judge of the fact that it was a good camera or not. But I believe it's held out pretty well. Even to this day, if there's good sunlight outside, this phone takes some crispy photos that you can post online. The front 8-megapixel camera, it's great as well. I'll post some selfies here, which will just showcase the fact that this has a great portrait mode in the front as well. And even for the rear camera, although it's a single camera, it can do software blur or like the portrait mode really well. So I'll throw in a couple of pictures about that too. The other thing about this phone that I liked at the time I bought it was the battery life. So this phone came with around 3500 milliamp hours battery, which lasted a day easily for me. Although the past couple of years it's degraded because it's gone through so many battery cycles, but even now with light or medium usage I can go through a day easily with this phone, and that's about it. The live wallpaper here, it's pretty neat. I'm not sure if you can see, but there's like a flock of birds flying across the wallpaper here, so that's pretty neat. It's like a live wallpaper by Google. Love that feature as well. Still snappy, and overall I believe Google makes the best software experience on Android, and obviously they have to because they're like the makers of Android. But yeah, I'll try to make another video where I talk about why I did not buy the Pixel 5 and I ended up buying the iPhone, but that's something I'll talk about in a future video. Apart from that, that's it for this video. I hope you guys liked it, enjoyed it. Give me a likes if you like the videos, leave a comment, and please subscribe to the channel for any future content. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks.